After deeply researching the history and culture of skateboarding, reading Joe Gould's Teeth, a book by Harvard historian Joe Lepore, and conducting a formal oral history interview with a Columbia skateboarder, Jeremy Tobert, for this final course, I present this final presentation in the South Carolina Honors College Class 326, a podium to call their own, retracing skateboarding's journey to the Olympics. In my final presentation, I seek to answer the following questions. Who is Toe? Jeremy Tobert is the candidate selected for my interview. He was born in Fort Campbell, Kentucky on March 28, 1981 and raised on Fort Jackson in Columbia. He picked up skateboarding as a hobby on the fort, but wasn't exposed to the full culture of skateboarding until he moved off the fort and into central Columbia. Toe worked as a camp counselor for kids learning to skateboard in a state-funded program and won the first street skate competition in Columbia. The interview includes descriptions of skate parks in Columbia, dynamics of Toe's close-knit skating community, and many stories of triumph and turmoil in the sport, including a gory recount of every hospitalization Toe has faced from resulting injuries. I mean, how many times have you been hospitalized? We'll go to that question.
Shit. I stepped on nails on both feet. I've had a nail go completely through my foot, like a 4-inch nail. Mm-hmm. I mean, I broke my arm, my radius of my ulna. I broke my big toe. Countless of stitches. I busted my eye open. I've had 5 staples in my skull. Oh, busted my knee. My latest is my knee. I just had a knee surgery like 2.5 years ago. I busted my knee at a punk rock show. I had nothing to do initially with skateboarding. Never had my knee looked at. Went down this handrail and landed, but my leg just kind of like went out of joint and back in real fast, and I was laying in the dirt, just breathing in dirt, and I was really bad. And then finally I went to go get my knee looked at, and the doctor was like, how long has this been going on? It's like 13 years. I've been skateboarding once since then. Mm-hmm. And I do dearly miss skateboarding. 20 something times I've been to the emergency room or hospital because of skateboarding.
How does the history of skateboarding predict its present as the center of gravity for a sect of American counterculture and its future as a hyper-coordinated Olympic sport? It begins on the beaches of California in the 1950s, where surfers spend their days chasing waves in the sun. Genius strikes when these surfers imagine surfing the streets, and young people attach wheels from their roller skates to long wooden boards. Soon this concept attracted toy companies, inspired companies such as Vans and Converse, birthed surf and skate shops, and attracted American youth from coast to coast. Before long, skate parks can be easily found with the help of print publishing such as Thrasher. These parks are second home to the youth who find strength, independence, and freedom on their boards. Community is essential to skateboarders. When I asked Toe how many hours he spent skating with his friends on an average week, he replies, "How many hours of daylight did we have?" Later adding that they often skated late into the night as well. Kids, teens, and adults all across the globe participate in this adrenaline rush of a sport. The skateboard world is a vast network with magazines, movies, celebrities, and the rise of the internet connected it even more, with YouTube compilations, tutorials, chat rooms, interviews, blogs, and then suddenly there's nothing you can't learn or try. The foundation of the nature and culture is a brave heart and a daring, if not rebellious, spirit.
Like, mixed between punk rock and hippie kids and hip-hop kids. It was just a wild, wild bunch of skaters.
Varying branches of alternative counterculture sects all fit together in one larger community, a community whose culture values hard work, determination, and physical coordination. There lies the intensity, but in contrast, skateboarding also requires grace, artistry, and loyalty.
Did I ever think skateboarding would get me to the place I am at now? You know, it's kind of hard to say because the journey in the middle is what I enjoy the most, so.
Through oral history, the smaller details paint the larger picture. Through Toe's retold stories, we gather information more detailed and personal than could be found in a textbook. Researching the history prior to the interview and asking questions geared toward a broader historical concept are two strong practices for conducting oral history interview. When interviewees pause to think, let them find the words they're looking for. Personal questions can be just as interesting, if not more, than the ones about general history. Be thorough, or you might miss the one question you want to ask the most. Is there anything about skateboarding that I have not asked you?
Why'd they call me Toe?
Yes.
We were at our friend Nathan's backyard pool. I get out of the pool to dry off, and Daniel's just like, dude, what's wrong with your feet? It's like, there's nothing wrong with my feet. What's wrong with your feet, dude? It's like, he put his foot next to mine. I was like, oh, shit. And then I started looking at everyone else's feet. I noticed that my toes were a little larger than everyone else's, my big toes. And Daniel coined Pinocchio toe on me. He said that every time I lie, my toes will grow. A lot of the skateboarders in this town didn't know my name was Jeremy until I got married.